Hello, welcome to the Apex Networks training for the RMS system. This is part of our online training program developed by Apex Networks to assist you in getting the very most from your software. This short video will cover Fleet Manager. We recommend you play this video on a separate device from that you are setting your system up on. This will allow you to pause, rewind, and keep pace of your progress without having to switch screens. The Fleet Manager application on RMS is designed to enable you to totally manage your fleet. Whether you have frontline recovery vehicles, courtesy cars, service vans or plant, such as forklifts etc., any vehicle that you wish to deploy on a recovery job must be entered into the Fleet Manager system before you can do this. To get to the Fleet Manager application, click on the menu button at the top right of the screen and select the fleet icon. Once in the application, you will see the familiar RMS orange menu bar with six buttons on it. The first button is Fleet Vehicle List, which is the Fleet Manager homepage and will bring you back to your list of vehicles. Under this button is Import Fuel Invoices. This allows you to merge your invoices against the vehicles in Fleet Manager. This function is only used where drivers do not enter their fuel purchases on their PDAs. Next is Update Vehicle Mileages. This will allow you to update vehicle odometer readings if required to give a more accurate reporting function for MPG reports, along with any service intervals that are in the maintenance schedule. The last in this list is New Vehicle. This will give you a new template for a fleet vehicle. An integral part of the RMS Fleet Manager application is a comprehensive accident management module, which allows you to keep a track of any accidents or claims. The Accidents List button will give a list of any reported accidents that have been added to any individual vehicle in Fleet Manager. There is a tab for this in each vehicle file, and we will look at this later. The MOT List will give the list of vehicles and their MOT booking or due date. This is also available as part of the RMS automated reporting function, as is Maintenances, which is the next button along. The Auto Emails is the next in this line and allows email reporting on MOT due or overdue and road tax and maintenance due. This function has a second tab. This is for email notifications. When set up, the recipient will be emailed immediately that there is a failed daily check, a failed inventory check, or a new defect reported. Next is the reporting function, and here you can pick from Insurance Register, which will give a list of all vehicles currently on your vehicle road risk insurance policy or policies. Fleet Planner will give you a view of your Fleet Planner year by year, or depot by depot if you are using multiple depots. Vehicle Cost Report will give you a rundown of vehicle costs and expenditure. It is important to use the PO system in order to get the most from this function. The MPG reports will set the fuel used against mileage or odometer entries to give a miles per gallon report that will show efficient driving habits, as well as a form of audit to ensure that all fuel purchased by your company is accounted for. Next is Open Accident Claim. Apex RMS has a comprehensive accident management facility, which allows you to log and keep track of any accidents that your vehicles are involved in. This report will show any claims that are still live. Ancillary Checklist will show a list of all ancillaries fitted to any of your fleet. Ancillaries are anything that is bolted to the chassis cab, such as recovery bodies, spec lifts, beacons, winches, etc. The Inventory Checklist will give a list of inventory items that should be on all of your fleet vehicles. Inventory items are anything that should be part of the kit for that vehicle that isn't bolted down, for example, first aid kit, fire extinguishers, road cones, broom, shovel, straps, etc. The Depreciation Report will give you a list of any items, trucks or exceptional spend equipment, along with purchase date and value, with the depreciation to date. The Driver Fuel Purchase Report will give you a report within a date period and by single driver if you wish, including date, which vehicle, the odometer reading, quantity of fuel in litres, how much was paid and where it was purchased from. It's important to note that this will only be accurate if your drivers are using the PDA app to log fuel purchases. The Driver Daily Vehicle Check Report can be done within a specific time frame, giving the date and time, also which vehicle, the driver that did it, the outcome, with the number of failed items, if any, but also the amount of time that the vehicle check took from start to finish. The next button is Setup, and here you can configure most of the parameters for your Fleet Manager system. First in the drop-down is Vehicle Types. Here you can add to the list of vehicle types to ensure that all of your fleet is covered. Fuel types is next, and this can cover the different locations that you may purchase fuel from or different fuel cards. You can also set up bunkering here if you have your own fuel on site. Maintenance categories is where you can set up the different maintenance categories to set up your planners for each vehicle. Details of how to set this up is covered off in a separate tutorial video, Fleet Maintenance. After this is service levels, and this is where you can set any service level agreements that you have and then apply them in each fleet vehicle file. Next is compliance levels, and this is where you can set the required compliance levels for your fleet vehicles. Inventory items is where you can compile a list of items that are part of the vehicle's kit and need to not only stay on the vehicle, but need to be audited or accounted for in date and good working order. Once the items are listed, they can then be applied to the inventory list for each vehicle, then checked and accounted for on the driver PDA, as well as by printout as part of the preventative maintenance inspection. Insurance companies will give a list of insurers that your company uses, primarily for road risk and goods in transit, but also can be used for premises or public liability, etc. Daily check templates will give you a list of daily check templates. Apex RMS allows you to customize these to fit your fleet range and make them relevant to the different types of vehicles in your fleet. You can also add specific items to certain vehicles, such as AdBlue, etc. These specific daily checks can then be applied to each vehicle in your fleet, which will help you to evidence a proactive attitude in your company towards daily vehicle checks and vigilance towards compliance. The livery types allows you to flag any of your fleet that may have livery specific to a work provider and therefore may not be able to attend jobs sent by other work providers. These are applied in the actual vehicle file. Maintenance schedules are applied to each vehicle on your fleet and will reflect the maintenance items relevant to that type of vehicle. There is a tutorial that deals with fleet maintenance. Reminder settings allow you to adjust, if you require, the amount of notice that the Apex RMS software will give you before an event. For example, a reminder email 15 days before tax is due or 30 days before an MOT. To the right, you have a registration search field and then the chat bubble for online chat with other system users who are currently logged on. Next, there are two rows of buttons with reminder counters. These are here for scheduled maintenance due, scheduled maintenance booked, outstanding defects, defects booked, MOT due, warranty expiring soon, road tax expiring soon, daily checks failed, inventory checks failed. By being able to look at these buttons whilst on the Fleet Manager screen at any point, the Fleet Manager can be completely up to speed with any critical operations that are either due or scheduled. They can then access a list of these by clicking on the appropriate button. Below this is a search and filter section, which allows you to refine your vehicle search by depot or by vehicle status and type. On from this is a list of your fleet. By clicking on anyone, you can access the full vehicle file. When you open a vehicle file, there will be two rows of tabs, separated by the vehicle registration number and fleet number. On the first tab, Main Details, you will see the first three fields are for registration number, fleet number, and buddy number. The reg number is the registration number currently shown on the vehicle. The next is fleet number. This is applied by the system and cannot be manually entered or changed. It is a one-off number identifier and will remain with this vehicle for its life with you and will not be reused when the vehicle leaves your service. The next is the buddy number. This is what you usually refer to this vehicle as and is the name or number that the system will apply to the job. Buddy numbers can be changed and are often used as an identifying mark that may relate to an individual depot or base. Also, registration numbers can be changed for cherished numbers, etc., and this is why we have a fleet number that remains constant, so that all records for maintenance, fuel usage, and costs can follow this. The majority of fields in the main details are fairly self-explanatory. The weights can be a useful aid to the controllers. By adding the KSW, curbside weight, and the GVW, gross vehicle weight, this will give you a payload. By adding the GTW, gross train weight, will give you the limitations of trailer weight. The date on insurance will add this vehicle to your insurance register in the reporting section, and the tax expiry date will trigger the road tax reminder in the auto email notifications. Livery type can refer to vehicles that are liveried differently from your other fleet vehicles, such as Green Flag or Alliance dedicated vehicles that shouldn't normally attend work from other work providers. By setting this, it will flag up to the controller that the vehicle is not of the correct livery to attend this job. Please note that it will not prevent this vehicle being applied to any job. The reason for this is that if there was an urgent job, for instance a child locked in a car with the keys, no one is likely to complain that a Green Flag vehicle attended if that was the only vehicle available or was the closest. There is also a place to add images of each vehicle and a tick box to mark if the vehicle is currently on O or operator's license. This will then flag up on the controller's drop-down when the driver and vehicle is applied to the job. The next tab is marked Technical. You can add some very useful information here, specifically in relation to the VIN and engine numbers, along with the compliance for LES and ULES. Cab type and cab capacity can be added here. This reflects passenger seating and should exclude the driver. When the vehicle is selected for a job, your RMS system will compare passenger numbers with cab capacity and give a pop-up alert to the controller if there are more passengers than seats in the truck that is deployed. There is also a tyre plan, which can assist if a vehicle has a puncture whilst out on a job. The fuel card or cards for this truck can be added here, along with their PIN number, which can be useful if the driver is using an unfamiliar truck. Next is an ancillary list, where you can list all of the items bolted onto the chassis cab of a truck, such as a recovery body, second car lift, beacons, winch, etc. This is a useful part of the system that not only allows you to log the high-value items in your fleet that may be overlooked, but serial numbers are useful to have, especially when ordering parts. There is also space to add a depreciation for items of high value, such as winches and beacons, specifically when they are replaced. The depreciation of these items will show on your reporting. Inventory items can be anything that the truck carries for its everyday duties that are not bolted on, such as road cones, broom, shovel, first aid kit, etc. These lists can be copied from one truck to another for ease of setting up. For example, if you have a fleet of slide beds, they can all have the same inventory list. Once the list is complete, the driver can, when required, do an inventory list check on their vehicle on their PDA. The inventory list can also be printed for periodic inspections. Fuel usage will log each refuel for this vehicle if it is done on the driver's PDA or if they are imported from fuel invoices or statements from your fuel card provider. This function cannot be mixed and matched. You will either need to do it one way or the other for accurate fuel usage. This function can also be used to populate reports and manual entries if required. Mileage will keep an update of any mileage on a vehicle, whether listed on a daily check or fuel entry. These can also be added manually. Warranties will give you a list of any warranty items that you have on your fleet vehicle, and you can add new warranty items as you go. There is a notification on the main fleet screen to show any warranty items that are due to go out of date. The last tab on this row is for any service agreements that you may have on particular fleet vehicles. The top row of tabs begins with the vehicle details. This will allow navigation of the lower tabs. Next is maintenance. This will list previous maintenance items and allow you to add new ones by clicking on the button at the top right-hand side. There is also an export button to allow you to create a list of the maintenance items. MOT is next and will log all of the MOT tests logged on the system. There is also a button to log and book a new MOT. Defects will show a log of any defects with a button to create a new defect. Each defect will carry its own report number, who raised it, what the defect is, along with who dealt with the rectification and the current status. Next is accidents. RMS has an accident management function and allows you to list any accidents along with any attachments, such as images and statements, which will allow you to keep an accurate track of any incidents. This is a private function and any information held here is not shared with anyone that you don't want it to be, such as insurers or third parties. Costs and purchases is the next tab. Here you will find any purchase orders that have content relating to this vehicle, any workshop repair jobs that have been invoiced on your internal account, as well as any sundry costs. A sundry cost is a cost that has been applied to this vehicle that is not part of a workshop job or purchase order. An example perhaps could be for valeting, where a blanket invoice has been presented for a group of vehicles, so you can apply an individual cost, similarly when you tax several vehicles on one check. The next tab is Daily Checks. This is where you will find every daily check that your driver does on this vehicle. If the vehicle has failed its daily check, an email will have been generated for the person selected in the Auto Email option. On each daily check line, you will see the time and date stamp when it was completed, along with the daily check template name. These templates are fully customizable within the system under the Setup function. You will also see the driver's name that did it, the mileage or odometer reading, the number of failed or advisory items if there was any, the outcome, and a tick box if there was anything to deal with to show that it has been dealt with or it's in hand. Click on a line to open and it will show the content of the check along with any relevant detail and the signature of the driver that did it, with any images if they were taken. Next is Documents. Here you can upload and store any documents that you wish to keep in this vehicle file. After this is Depreciation. This feature will enable you to have a depreciation value month by month for this vehicle. This depreciation will show on the profit and loss reporting. Finally is History, and this will show any alterations and additions made to this vehicle from the time that it was added to your fleet. It will show when the alteration, change or addition was made, with time and date, the content of the change, and the name of the person who did it. This is why it is important for each system user to have their own login and password.